Former Vice President Joe Biden, he's run for president twice before, unsuccessfully. He's never before been the front runner. Now that he is towering over all the other declared Democratic candidates, his almost five decades in public life are getting some real scrutiny. On top of that list, his record on civil rights during his younger days as a U.S. Senator. CNN's Jeff Zeleny has exclusively obtained some letters written by Biden himself.
Everybody asks, you know, what kind of Democrat? I'm an Obama-Biden Democrat, man.
After 8 years alongside President Obama, Joe Biden is coming back as a solo act.
I'm ready to go.
With his long record, facing a new look under the spotlight of the 2020 campaign.
Gentlemen and ladies of the Senate.
One chapter receiving fresh scrutiny comes from his earliest years in the Senate, when he strongly opposed mandatory school busing. It was designed to achieve integration and a more equitable education. It was the mid-1970s. Biden favored desegregation, but not through busing. What's less known is how he followed the lead of some of the Senate's most fervent segregationists. In a series of never-before-published letters reviewed by CNN, the strength of Biden's opposition to busing comes into sharper focus. On March 25, 1977, Biden wrote, "My bill strikes at the heart of the injustice of court-ordered busing. It prohibits the federal courts from disrupting our educational system." Biden sought and received support from Mississippi Senator James Eastland, the Democratic chairman of the Judiciary Committee and a leading symbol of Southern resistance to desegregation. He frequently spoke of blacks as, quote, "an inferior race." Biden reflected on that era earlier this year.
They're a bunch of racists. You know, there was, you know, James O. Easton of Mississippi, Strom Thurmond, and so on. There were nine guys who were in the caucus that were, you know, I ran against in the civil rights movement.
But he did not say that Eastland and others were partners on several of Biden's anti-busing bills. On June 30th, 1977, Biden wrote, "Dear Mr. Chairman, I want you to know that I very much appreciate your help during this week's committee meeting in attempting to bring my anti-busing legislation to a vote." Then in 1978, Biden again asked Eastland to put his anti-busing bill before the full Senate, writing, "Your participation in floor debate would be welcomed." Four decades later, after building a strong civil rights record, Biden stands by his opposition to busing, arguing it did not address institutional racism. Most busing programs in America were later abandoned after bringing more hardship than equal opportunity to all students. A Biden spokesman telling CNN, "Joe Biden is today and has been for more than 40 years in public life one of the strongest and most powerful voices for civil rights in America." Ronnie Dunn is a professor at Cleveland State University who co-wrote the book Boycotts, Busing, and Beyond. He says Biden's opposition to busing is not disqualifying, but warrants explanation.
Those letters I find somewhat surprising given Senator Biden's or Vice President Biden's current position and potential candidacy for the presidency and his position as a liberal. Those are issues that he's obviously going to have to answer for.
You said surprising. Surprising in what way?
Well, the fact that he would solicit the support of staunch segregationists, James Eastland, as well as Jesse Helms, introducing legislation as opposing busing at that time.
So the question facing Biden is how he reconciles nearly a half century in public life with today's Democratic Party. Of course, Jake, one of his biggest pieces of experience is that experience and long record. That also is one of his biggest challenges.